Well, good morning. So I've just come down to Constitution Dock. It's the morning of the Sydney to Hobart line honours happening earlier this morning. A bit early for me. 1:30, I think, Blackjack crossed the line. And as we swing out here, there's been three yachts finished so far. Out here we can see Scallywag. And then this is the winner moored up alongside the dock, which is Blackjack. And then Alive is off in the distance. Yeah, pretty exciting to be down here for the big race finish, sort of finish. Yeah, pretty awesome. This is Blackjack, the winner.
Sydney Hobart, the Great Race South is on. 628 nautical miles to Hobart.
Bruce Gould says go and they're away. Law Connect, top of the screen. Next to them is Blackjack, then Scallywag's got a very good start. Here's Law Connect, look at that massive sail. Absolutely powering down the harbour now. There'll be 18 to 20 knots of boat speed. What a sight.
There's the four start lines. What a magnificent sight. One of the great sights in Australian sport. One of the great sights in the world of yachting. And look at those Maxis down the western side of the harbour. Charge you away.
So we're just down the harbour, and in front of us we have the line honours winners Blackjack, and then Scallywag just off in front of it. So this is Custom House Hotel, and celebrations are in full swing. I can see the crew of Scallywag and Law Connect are well and truly into the schooners. Scallywag sitting at the front, and the Law Connect guys are sitting in there, and it's party central. So just a short walk back from the dock to our accommodation. So we've decided to stay in a hotel for the next three nights to make the most of the atmosphere down here at Constitution Dock. We're going to a festival today, which is a Taste of Tasmanian festival, which is like a food and wine festival. And we'll be in here for New Year's Eve as well. So yeah, that should be interesting. Nice change for us to be out of the van and into, I guess, a nice hotel. And the good thing is that Salamanca Inn is basically, I don't know, I'm looking at it now, I can see the entrance to the festival and I can see the entrance to our hotel, so it's probably about 500 meters away. So very handy. Sharon's done a good job of securing that for us in very difficult times to get accommodation. So yeah, looking forward to the next few days.
Thank you. goes up, gives a bit of a, that's it.
So at the Taste of Summer Festival in Tasmania, we have to say it is one of the best festivals that we've ever been to. Really well organised, as you've seen by some of the footage. Lots and lots of options for food and drink, and very spaced out. There's no queues, which I like, people that know me. Yeah, it's really awesome actually, and set on a beautiful day, overlooking the water. We've seen the end of the Launceston to Hobart race. So there's three yacht races happening at once. The Sydney to Hobart, Launceston to Hobart, and also the Melbourne to Hobart. So you've got all these yachts finishing and great atmosphere. It's exactly what we ordered. So yeah, hope you enjoy. So we're just sitting down at the official finish line for the Sydney to Hobart race, and we've just got a couple of yachts about to cross the line. So yeah, pretty awesome spot here. Finish line is just over here. This boat here, which is the boat called Sylvia, so we've been following Expedition Drenched on YouTube. So they've been parked up here off the finishing line. Sharon ran into Nate, the skipper, in Target the other day in town.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. He's a pretty nice guy. So yeah, we've been in Hobart for 3 days now.
Yep.
And it's been really good few days, hey. We've had so much fun, and for Darren and I to be able to watch the boats coming in is something we've always wanted to do. So yeah, the Sydney to Hobart yacht race at this end has been fantastic. I think I'm going to try and get to Sydney one day and see them.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome actually. Yeah. Pretty awesome to be in Hobart for this. The weather's been
beautiful,
super nice. Had a nice couple of days. So yeah, we've got one more night, New Year's Eve tonight, so
party on.
One more night in Hobart before we head back to the van, and we leave Hobart in a couple of days' time.
So what are we doing today, Dazza?
So we're visiting the Mona Museum.
Yeah, we've heard a few things about it, so we thought, let's come and check it out.
Not my usual thing that I enjoy, but we've got an open mind. Okay, so we just finished our museum tour, and how would you rate it, Sharon?
About a 1 out of 10.
1 out of 10. I actually thought that the construction of the museum was really well done.
Yeah,
you go through all these
amazing
tunnels and the engineering feats within there, but I wouldn't classify it as being interesting at all. I thought it might have been just me, but Sharon thought the same.
And also, they've crowded so many people in there, it felt claustrophobic.
Yeah.
And it is, they've, you know, had another little bit of a COVID scare here in Tassie. And it says they're checking vaccinations, which they're not. So, yeah, sorry, thumbs down for me. I really just want to go home.
To top it off, they have the only vegan burger place that I've ever seen.
Yeah, like...
they're advertising burgers with fake bacon, and that's just a showstopper for me.
Apparently the only meat they serve is us. Well, anyway, if you really...
so that really sums it up.
If you like wacky things, like really, really wacky things, come to Mona.
So for $30 a ticket?
Yeah, skewing.
Depends on what your preferences are, but save you $60 for a nice bottle of Pinot.
And it's a couple of hours we'll never get back in our life. It's crap.
Well, good morning. Today we're moving on from Hobart. So we've spent last week in Hobart, which has been really nice. So 3 days in the city, watching the Sydney to Hobart race. New Year's Eve. Been back at the showgrounds here for a couple of days now, and today we're heading sort of up into the middle, which is the last place we really haven't seen in Tasmania yet. So we're heading towards Bothwell, up towards Miena tonight. Not sure where we're going to stay, and then we're catching up with some other friends in the next couple of days up near Meander in the centre. So yeah, it's our little camp that we've had here, which has been quite nice. Overlooking Mount Wellington, which you can't see at the moment because it's covered in cloud.
So we're just on our way through the middle of Tassie. We're headed to the northern region. We're not really sure where we're going to stay tonight. We've just passed through a little town called Miena or Miena, and we're at the Great Lakes Lookout. So, bloody big lake. Lakes, and about 1,050 meters above sea level. So yeah, we've come from way down here in Hobart today, and we've literally gone through this part into Bothwell, which we were going to stay, but they didn't have a very dog friendly park there, and now we've driven all the way through to here. We did stop in Arthur's Lake here in the pump house to have a bit of a look, but it's pretty chockers. It is the last day of the New Year's weekend, so anyway, we've gone through back through Miena and around the Great Lake, and we're here. So yeah, probably going to end up somewhere around the Meander Valley tonight at this stage.
Oh, we're just getting started. Don't know what to do with our heads, so we keep them up while we dance all night. You're feeling like a party, and if you only give me one chance, we can make this memory that's for life. Yeah, you're in good company. To overthink it, come over and vibe with me, vibe with me, vibe with me. Oh, I'm right where I wanna be, and it ain't that complicated, cause you got a hold of me, a hold of me.
I think we're at the highest point we'll be able to drive in Tassie. I think so. It's 1.2, just over 1.2 k's up. So I'll just show you how far up here. Yeah, so it's 13 degrees too, so it's not freezing.
Yeah, we're up here.
Yeah. Correct. Yeah, like I said. resolve it, cause we got so much to celebrate. Yeah, we do. So now it'll be the let's go down. Put it in motion. You know there's no
stopping us down. Yeah, it must be magic I found. Well, hello. So where we ended up after our drive out of Hobart was at a farm called Top Farm, which is just outside the town. Got up and wrapped the 100 metres, and we came out outside through about 300 metres now, and this is a beautiful campsite. Very spacious. We've got this whole area to ourselves. We have some friends arriving later on today, and this area, which is obviously our camp, is through the trees there, is what's called Huntsman Lake. There's no evidence that that's been named after the spider. Spent the first night here last night. Pretty cool place. And for $22 a night, all off-grid living, we think it's pretty good value.